Hello students, hope all of you are fit and fine. Let's continue the discussion of WordPress, that is content management system using WordPress. In our previous lecture we have gone through the many section of entire dashboard, that is post, how to adding the post, how to adding the categories, how to adding the tag. Then we go for media, for adding the new medias. Medias can be image, PDF, doc, etc., etc. Then we have gone for adding the page. Then we have gone for comments. So this first portion we have completed into the previous section. Then we have started with the customization of the site. Into the customization of site, even we have discussed about many sections like site identity, colors, header image, background image, menu, that we have completed into the previous lecture. Now today we will discuss about widgets. So students, first it should be clear that what is widgets. So widgets is actually a one type of fixed functionality which is previously designed by the developer, which you can directly attach as an add-on in your page, that is called as widgets. Many types of paid and free widgets are available into the market which we can use for our general purpose. Right now for the learning purpose we are using only the free widgets which is supported by the WordPress. So just click onto the widgets, it returns an option that is called as sidebar. Here I would like to make one thing clear, whatever the widgets you get attached with this particular web page will be displayed into the sidebar. This is actually the sidebar of our website. Let's clearly look at over here. Say for example I am executing my home page. Then this is called as header. This is the header. This is body. This is sidebar. And this one is footer. This is the standard section of any website. For example, the website that I have created through Core PHP, even it contains the same section. This is my header. This is my body, and the last one is my footer. This is my footer section. Whenever you visit any page of the website, the intermediate content will get changed according to the page, but my header and footer remains same. Say for example, right now I am into the home page. Suppose I am visiting a BCS staff detail. Then my in between portion gets changed, but my header and footer remains same. Suppose I am visiting the course, which is another page. Then my header remains same and footer remains same. Intermediate portion will get change. So same into the WordPress, header, footer and sidebar remains same and content gets changed page by page. So this was all about the sidebar. Now just click onto the sidebar which is available into the widgets. By default, these widgets are added into the site. Means there is a search, there is a recent topic, there is a comments, archives, categories, meta tags, everything is available. Suppose I want to add something new, then it can be done using this add widgets. Means just click on add widgets. Here you will see the list of widgets which is available by free of cost in WordPress. Just click any of the widgets. Suppose I am selecting the calendar widgets. That calendar widgets will be displayed at last. But for this, right now it is not published. That's why here it is not going to be show. We need to save and publish. Then refresh the page. It will display the calendar widgets over here. Now once the widgets is added, you can remove that particular widgets also by pressing the remove button. Save the changes and refresh the page. That will remove the widgets from sidebar. Remember one thing, widgets is only and only gets attached at the sidebar section of WordPress website. Now, suppose we want to make a change of any title which is already attached into the widgets. Means, suppose I want to change this current topic to something else. Actually, these are the posts. If you look at into the post section, you will find these two posts. Just select it and make a change over here from current topic to recent post. Whenever you make a certain change, it will be reflected over here. You will need to save it, and whenever we refreshed, the entire effect you will get over here. Students, to perform this activity in core PHP, it's very difficult. We need to write long logical line of code for the same, which is very easy into the WordPress. Now, this was all about actually a widgets. Next option is static front page. There is no requirement of handling this particular section, but it's there. That's why we are discussing about the same. The concept behind setting the static page is that instead of post, suppose we want to set any of our page that we have created as a front page, that means the landing page, then it can be done using this particular option. If you look at to the page section, there is a one page that already has been created with some write-up. Suppose you want to load that particular page instead of the post, then it can be done using this particular section. Right now this post are getting displayed over here, but instead of this it will display the page. So this is the difference between displaying. By default it displays the post. Suppose we want to change from post to page, then it can be done using this particular option. Now let's move ahead. This was all about the options which is available into the customizing of your site. Next to it, There are two more sections are there. That is next step, more actions. Actually, these are the shortcuts which we can directly perform from here, which we have already discussed into the customization of your site. Say for example, suppose I am clicking on write your first blog post. The page it will open is similar to the page when we have discussed about adding the new post. This one and this one both are same. So actually over the dashboard for creating the post, this one is given as a shortcut. Now, same like post, suppose we want to add new page, then it can be done using add new or add an about page. Means whenever you click on this particular link, it opens add new page, which can also be done using dashboard page add new page. So this one and this one both are same, no need to worry. This is just a shortcut given over here. Now the third option is view your site. It will return the preview of website that you have created. That means whatever the operations we have done for the learning purpose will be displayed as a preview over here. These are the next steps. Into the more actions, many other advanced options are given. That means suppose you directly want to go into the widget sections, then by clicking this particular option, user can go directly into the widgets. Generally, we are going into the widgets by clicking on customize your site, then widgets, then sidebar, then add new widgets, then we can add the widgets. But with the help of this particular option, directly you can browse all the widgets which is available into the WordPress. Then same like widgets, we can also browse the menu or menus that we have created. During the discussion of our content management system using WordPress, then the next topic is, suppose we want to turn off the comments which came by the post, then it can be done using this particular option. Now whenever we click this particular option, actually it redirects ourselves into the section called setting. Let's click on to this. Ultimately the setting menu gets open, where I would like to first say all of you that don't make any changes in this if you don't know anything more in detail about this particular section, because it might crash your WordPress and your WordPress execution get unconditionally stopped. But we should require to know about that, what actually has been done by this particular section. In this setting section, it contains many parts like default article setting, other comment settings, email me whenever, before a comment appears, comment moderation, comment blacklist, several sections of avatars like avatar display, avatar rating, default avatar, whatever you change over here need to be saved. We'll not go in depth about each and every section, but simply suppose I don't want user to feel the comments for the post that I have created, then I have to just remove this post tick. Whenever you select this one and press save button, whatever the post you create will not accept the comments. But students, I suggest whenever you create any post, accept the comments, because comments makes you more powerful to give maximum output for your work. Suppose we want to upgrade ourselves, then it can be done using reading the comments. So all these are the settings which we can perform for miscellaneous part of the turn of the WordPress. Now next one is learn more about getting started. It's actually a one type of help which is given by the WordPress free of cost, because WordPress is a non-paid programming language. We don't have to pay a single rupees for making a website through the WordPress. Now in this you will get an help about each and every topics of WordPress if you requires. In further discussion we'll go for theme and plugins. These are the separate chapters. At that time we will discuss about the same, but yet it will display over here as a menu. This is going to be open if your computer is connected with internet. If you are working offline, you will not get this particular website. So this is learn more about getting started. Same like this, another sections are at a glance, how many posts right now available into the WordPress will be displayed over here as a pinpoint. How many pages are there will be displayed over as a pinpoint. Which version of WordPress we are using with theme will be displayed over here. Is my website is search engine optimized or not? And directly I can update my WordPress to the latest version of WordPress which is available currently into the market will be displayed at a glance. Then even it shows the recent activities. That means the post that I have created, title will be displayed over here with the date and time. Then there is a quick draft. Suppose we want to create any draft quickly, then it can be possible over here. No need to use this thing right now. And at bottom you will see the WordPress news, latest news on 40th July 2020. WordPress 5.5 beta 2 version has been released by wordpress.org, which you can update or you can use for the same. What came in this particular WordPress version will be displayed over here. Need to read the same, and then you can go for updation of the website, WordPress. But I suggest all the students not to update your WordPress till I say for the same. Now students, Before going ahead, I would like to just show you the syllabus that whatever we have completed in WordPress, we have gone for unit number 1, that is OOP, where we have discussed about the class, property, visibility, constructor, destructor, inheritance, scope resolution operator, autoloading class, class constant, MySQL database handling with OOP. Then we have gone through the introduction, installation and configuration of WordPress in unit number 2, where as a first topic we have go for what is content management system. Then we go for introduction to WordPress. Then we have discussed about the few features of WordPress with advantages and disadvantages of WordPress. Then we have started the installation of WordPress. Then we have discussed about the directory and file structures. Means directory and file structure means whenever we have installed our WordPress into the C drive, XAMPP, htdocs, WordPress, these are the directories which has been created by the WordPress. In next session we will also go for the same that what actually resides in this particular directories and a particular file. So this was all about WordPress directories and file structure. Then we have learned the many sections of dashboard, that is the dashboard of WordPress with post, media, page, comment, customization and the other sections of WordPress, that is dashboard overview. We have also learned that how to edit, how to delete, post and pages. Even we have learned the same for category and tag. Then we have learned that how to add media in format of image, PDF, DOC, etc. into the post or page. Right now you can see that in this post, suppose I have attached one media onto the screen as given over here. Now from this topic, that is user role and capabilities, settings and updating of the WordPress with database structure, we will discuss in our next lecture. For handling user roles and capabilities and setting, we will refer this user section and this setting section, which covers these two part. And for updating the WordPress, we need to go for dashboard, and over there are updates. Right now there are 6 updates that we can perform if we require. Don't click on this right now, I will say later on. And then last we'll go for database structure. Means if you remembers, at the time of the installation of WordPress into the phpMyAdmin, we have created our database which is called as a WordPress. In that database, whenever the installation gets completed, many table comes inside that particular database. What is the purpose of each and every database table will be displayed into the database structure. So this was all about the brief overview of unit number 2, that is introduction installation and configuration of WordPress. So thank you very much students for listening me. In next lecture we'll go for this selected section. Thank you very much and have a nice day.